Leia here from leiafirstsight.com. In this video, we'll discuss the what and how behind the alkene reaction mechanisms.
In this video, I will take you through the mechanism of the acid-catalyzed hydration of alkenes. There are a number of different reactions that will put an alcohol group onto an alkene, and the most common one is the acid-catalyzed hydration. This is typically accomplished by using a strong acid, such as sulfuric acid or H2SO4. Now, just because we're saying that sulfuric acid is the reagent, this doesn't mean this is the only thing in solution. Recall from general chemistry that acid strength is measured on a pH scale, where pH is negative log of the H plus concentration. And while you don't have to perform this math in organic chemistry, it's important to remember the concept. If I tell you that I have a really strong acid where the pH is equal to 1, this simply means that I have one dissociated acid, or one H plus, for every 10 molecules of water. And if I have an acid with a pH of 2, still a very strong acid, that means I have one H plus for every 10 to the second, or 100, water molecules. This really means that you have your H2SO4 in a very large quantity of water, and that means water will always be available for the reaction. Let's look at the specifics of how the H2SO4 reacts with the water. If I do a standard dissociation reaction, H2SO4 will break down to give me an H plus and an HSO4 minus. Now, the HSO4 minus is a spectator ion, so we won't really look at it, but what we do care about is the H plus. When an H plus ion is placed in a solution of water, the electronegative oxygen will act as a nucleophile and reach out to grab the H plus. This will give me a molecule of H3O plus, or the hydronium acid catalyst. Hydronium is simply a water molecule with an H plus attached to it, since H plus is not going to be free floating in your solution. Now, anytime you see acid catalyzed reaction, regardless of what the acid is, if this reaction is aqueous, then you will always be able to use an H3O plus in your reactions rather than showing the acid. Taking that into account, we can now start the mechanism of acid-catalyzed hydration by simply placing H3O plus over the reaction arrow and assuming that something like H2SO4 is implied. I like to write H3O plus as a hydrogen bound to an OH2 because this shows me the hydrogen that is about to come off and makes it easier to draw out the reaction. Starting with the symmetrical butene, the pi electrons will act as the nucleophile, and the positive hydronium will act as the electrophile. As in the previous alkene reactions, the pi electrons reach out and grab the hydrogen. This causes the electrons between hydrogen and oxygen to collapse onto the oxygen, giving it back its lone pair. The intermediate for this reaction will have my hydrogen on either one of the carbon atoms, given that I started with a symmetrical molecule, and a carbocation forming on the second carbon that used to hold the double bond. Also formed in this reaction, I have my water molecule now with its two lone pairs of electrons and no charge. For this intermediate step, the positive charge makes the carbocation my electrophile, and the lone pairs of electrons on the electronegative oxygen makes water the nucleophile. This is a distinction to recognize in any acid solution. If the charges of this solution are between neutral and positive, then anything, even partially negative, will be a nucleophile in the solution. And because this is an acidic solution, make sure never ever to create negative charges in the solution. Going back to the reaction, the nucleophilic electrons on the water will reach out and attack the positive carbon, giving me another intermediate for this reaction, where I have my oxygen bound to the carbon and bound to two hydrogens. This oxygen now has just one lone pair and a formal charge of plus one. To get rid of this positive charge, I will bring in another water molecule, which will reach out with its lone pair of electrons to grab one of the partially positive hydrogens and return the lone pair of electrons to the oxygen. This gives me my final product, which is a 2-butanol having an OH where the carbocation was, and an H3O+, which is my acid catalyst regenerated. Recall that the definition of a catalyst is something that will speed up the reaction and will not get used up in the reaction itself. So if my hydronium takes part of the mechanism, then the hydronium has to be regenerated in the last step of the mechanism, as I have here. Now let's look at an example, starting with an asymmetrical alkene for my reactant. In this reaction of methyl cyclohexene with an acid catalyst, I will start the reaction in the same way. The nucleophilic pi electrons of the alkene will reach out and grab the hydrogen, causing the electrons between hydrogen and oxygen to collapse onto the oxygen. If I look at the structure formed by breaking the double bond, let's name the starting material so we can keep track of the steps. We'll start at the tertiary carbon 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. After breaking the double bond, I have the option to place the hydrogen in the tertiary position, giving me a carbocation in the secondary position, or the hydrogen secondary and the carbocation tertiary. And this is because when you break the carbon-to-carbon double bond, one of the carbons will get the hydrogen, the other one will be deficient in bonds and therefore have a formal charge of plus one. Comparing the stability of the carbocation, I have a secondary carbocation versus a tertiary carbocation. Since the secondary carbocation has fewer carbon neighbors, therefore is less stabilized, and the tertiary carbon having more carbon neighbors is more stabilized, the secondary will not form, and my intermediate will have a tertiary carbocation with a hydrogen placed in the secondary position. Another water molecule in solution will then reach out with its lone pair of electrons and attack the carbocation, giving me the oxonium intermediate, or positive oxygen intermediate. And finally, another water molecule in solution will reach out and grab that extra hydrogen, giving oxygen back its lone pair of electrons. This gives me a final product where the alcohol is placed on the most substituted carbon and the hydronium ion regenerated as my catalyst in solution. This placement of the alcohol in the tertiary position is in accordance with Markovnikov's rule, which tells you to place the carbocation intermediate in the most stable position. In future videos, I will address hydration mechanisms that don't necessarily follow Markovnikov's rule due to the catalyst or reagents being used in the mechanism.
I will be happy to answer any additional mechanism questions in my weekly review sessions, live, online, and from the comfort of your home. I also offer one-on-one private tutoring. Visit my website for more information. LeahFirstSci.com/organic chemistry.